Hey guys! In this video, I will show you how to draw a realistic guinea pig from a reference photo, step by step. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe so you'll be notified about my future videos. You can download the fur brushes, color palette, reference image and sketch file in the video description below for free. If you'd like to access more tutorials and get exclusive brush sets, please consider joining me on Patreon. The link is also in the video description. Now, if you are ready, let's get started! I'm going to Procreate, and instead of creating a new canvas, I will import the image with these cute guinea pigs. It's a copyright-free file that you can get from unsplash.com. If you have it saved to your gallery, just click on Photo and select it in Procreate Gallery as well. Before we proceed to work, I'd like to say a couple of words about this tutorial. I already have realistic animal tutorials on my YouTube and Patreon, but this time I decided to make it different. I will not only focus on working with fur brushes, but also teach you how to work with a reference photo, create a color palette, and make it to a clean sketch. There are easy ways to create a portrait sketch, such as tracing and using some Procreate tools to transform a photo into sketch. I show it in one of my Patreon videos. But if you are really interested in learning how to do it from scratch, make sure to watch this video without skipping that part. Now let's prepare the reference photo. We have three cutest guinea pigs on this image. But I'd like to draw only one of them, that is in the middle. Let's go to transformation menu and drag the image to the left. Also scale it. And place this guinea pig in the center vertically. Then I'll go to selection, pick rectangle, and outline the guinea pig on the right. I will swipe three fingers down and cut it. Now nothing will distract us. We will use the image on the left as the reference and use the right half of the canvas for sketching. With time, you can learn to see all the dimensions and angles on the reference and transfer them on your sketch. But if you find it difficult for now, there is a way to use the guidelines. I will show you how to create them. Let's go to Actions and enable Drawing Guide in the Canvas menu. Click Edit Drawing Guide and we'll get a 2D grid. We will need it to split the canvas into two equal parts and also to create horizontal guidelines. First of all, I will increase the grid size. I will make one of the lines match with the top of the head, and the other one will match with the paw. I will also change the color of the grid. Hope it will be still visible. And I will also enable assisted drawing, so we can create straight lines easily. Let's click Done. I want to use some bright color, like this green. And for sketching I will be using 6B pencil. But before that, I'd like to change one setting. Let me duplicate this brush and go to Apple Pencil settings. Here I will remove the tilt. Set everything to none. This way the thickness of the pencil will be constant and won't depend on the tilt. Then I will click Done. First of all, let's draw this vertical line to determine the middle of the canvas vertically. I'll set the brush size to around 26%. And since we have assisted drawing, we can just draw. Next, I will draw this horizontal line for the head and also determine the key features of the face. For instance, the height of the ear, then the other ear, the eye, also the beginning of the nose, which actually matches with the end of the ear. I will also determine the mouth the head at the bottom, and maybe the end of the body here. Now I also want to draw vertical guidelines, and here we can use negative space. Negative space is the area around the object, and it can help us see the dimensions. Here this grid works as the edge, and we can count it from here. Also, we can use the pencil to measure the space. Or if you have the grid, you can simply count the cells. I think I will remove the guide now. And continue working. But you can keep it. We still have drawing assist, so we can determine vertical guides. We can see the space from the edge and the height for this cheek. Let me draw a vertical line this way. And the edge of the canvas will work as the end of this part of the drawing. So we can count the distance from here for the right side of the guinea pig. I will draw a vertical line here, trying to keep the same distance. Starting approximately from here, we have the body. I think that's it for vertical lines. We can totally go here and remove assisted drawing. Now we will work with the angles. Let's determine them on the photo first. Here we can see this one. Let me draw here. Then another angle on the opposite side. Also on the head. And here. To repeat them on this part, we need to draw lines parallel to this. So I will draw a line from here, trying to keep the same angle. Then it'll go here for the head. We have this angle that goes a little inwards first, and then it will continue. I'm making these sketchy strokes with straight lines for now. Don't worry, we will clean it up later. Here we have the ear. We can totally draw it. It is slightly round. And then I will continue drawing the head. We have the top part determined. Let's also draw this angle. Here we have a small arc. We can try to round some angles already. And also at some distance from the cheek, we can see this white fur. Let's show it. It continues this way. It goes a little higher than the ear. It has this M shape. We can also measure the distance. All right. Goes down approximately until the eye. Here I'm not focused on the animal. I only draw what I see regarding the shapes. goes a little to the right. We also determined the mouth. Let's show it. I will first finish with the fur. It goes a little lower than this line. Then we have the lip. And the mouth. We can also draw the nose now. We already know the top, so we just need to draw it horizontally. It is more straight on this side and goes with an angle on the right. On top it is a little heart-shaped. And then it has these two arcs. We can draw the nostrils. Here it is less visible. And this one has a triangular shape. It has another arc in the middle. And then we can show more details inside the nose. Okay, I think we can totally draw the eye. We know the height, and from this white part, we can skip some distance. The beginning of the eye is located a little above the line. And it has this shape. I will draw a circle inside. We can also show this light reflection. And then draw this ear. Here it will be better if we check the distance from the right side of the head. This is the height. And then I will try to repeat its shape. It goes with another curvy line and matches with the head. Goes a little inside here with its natural shape. Okay, we can also show the fur here. And it will transition to this cheek. All right. We can also determine the white part of the fur under the lip. I think this part may go a little down. Then we have white fur here. If we determine all the colors of the fur on the sketch, it will be easy to color it later. Let me round it here. You can actually use eraser. It goes this way. Then I will make it more round here. and then we can finish drawing the head. From here it'll go to the side. Let's finish this white fur. And also draw the shape of this cheek. We have this angle that we need to repeat. I will first draw a parallel line and then round it. Transition here. We have some white fur going on the neck. I think we can also draw another line here. And from here, show this white fur schematically. Something like this. Just some curves. We will work it out with shading. Let me erase it here. And I think this will be the end of the portrait. Of course, it will be fluffy. Let's see what else we can add on the sketch. I think we can draw the whiskers. The ones that are very visible. Some are curvy. Go up. Here. Let me fix this ear a little. I'll add a volume to it. And erase the sketch here. Okay. I will check it all once again. I think I will make the lip a little wider here. All these details are quite important because later it will make the drawing look like photo, so we can be accurate even on this stage. I'll fix the shape of the ear a little. It goes more with an angle. And ends on this line. Okay, maybe we can also show this line. That will help us with the shading later. Okay, let me clean up the sketch. And I will see you in the next part of the tutorial. Well, I spent some more time on the sketch and I didn't want to make the tutorial too boring and too long. I think most of you can't wait to proceed to coloring. So I will just tell you in short what I did. I created a new layer above the sketch and using the same brush, but this time black color, I outlined it once again, made a few adjustments. For example, I added this line to separate the orange and white colors, also fixed these shapes a little, and added the shape for this orange color around the eye, that is a little lighter. That's it. I'm going to use this sketch. And to start coloring, we can create one more layer and place it under. We can also lower the opacity of the sketch. I'll set it to 30%. First, I want to apply base colors that I will pick right from the photo. I want to start with the biggest area, that is this furry one on the face and on the right side. And I want to make it one color. Let's try to pick it right from the photo. I want to select some neutral brown color. This way we will be able to go lighter and darker while shading. I will create a new color palette and put this color here. If you want, you can download the color palette and use it, or try to create your own by picking the colors from the photo. I think it will be a good practice. To apply basic colors, I'm going to use a brush from airbrushing set. It will be medium hard airbrush. If you have your own favorite brush, of course you can use it. I will set the size of the brush to 50% and start outlining the head. We don't have to be very accurate because we will smudge the edges later using fur brushes. Just make sure you don't go outside the edge a lot, because the shape of the guinea pig may look a little different in the end. I will also paint this cheek and go down to this side. Stop here. Then I will paint on the right side. I am crossing the sketch a little on the left. Once it is outlined, we can increase the brush size and paint the area inside. Next, I want to pick a color from the area around the nose. Let's pick some shade of light pink. So we can shade it later. This one will work, I think. Let me also add it to the palette. I will lower the brush size and paint this light area on the same layer, following the lines of the sketch. And since the sketch layer is on top, we still can see the lines. This fur under the lip is also light. And then it goes to the side, like this. Transitioning to the neck. We have this area outlined on the right. So let's follow the sketch as well. I'll make the size a little bigger and paint faster. Here I will lower the brush size. We have some white fur here that goes to the left side. We can also add it. This is also done. Next, I will paint this small area here. We can pick the color. That is a shade of dark brown. Let's just make sure it's not too dark. I think we can make it a little lighter. Yes, that's better. I will also add it in the color palette. And paint this way, keeping a gap on the left. I will lower the brush size and paint this way. And here we can see that the color is getting darker. So I will pick it from the area closer to the edge, but also try to make it not too dark. This color will work. Let me place it in the second column. And then I will paint this area. First outline it, then increase the size to paint inside. This brush has a soft edge. That will work better while smudging. We can now toggle the sketch to check if we have any white gaps between the colors, and fix them if needed. This is fine, I think. Next, I will paint the ears. And I will pick the color from the photo as well. Just make sure it is not totally black, because we will need to add shading on it. It can be some shade of dark brown. I will place this color under the previous one and paint this ear. This time I will try to make this line smooth on the edge. It may be not easy, since the streamline of the brush is not set to maximum in the settings. And we can't use quick shape tool here. So we need to be very careful while drawing. But it is actually fun. and can be very relaxing. Once it is outlined, I will just paint the area inside and check it by removing the sketch. It looks fine. Let's draw the second ear using the same color. I will also try to make smooth lines, especially on the left edge, because here we will smudge it using fur brushes. Here I will lower the size and remove the sketch to see the borders. Then I will paint this empty area inside the ear. This is also done. I think we can even paint the area around the eye using the same color. And we don't have to paint it entirely. Can be only the outline. And even though we will smudge it later, I will still try to make it smooth. I'll check it. Maybe fix a little. And to draw the eyeball, I'll create another layer above this one. This way it will be easier to shade it. I think I will use pure black color for that. So we can go to the disk and double tap here to get it. Let me remove this layer so I can see the sketch better and make it smooth. I think it is also a very good exercise to train your hand. No streamline, no quick shape tool, no other tools. Just pure hand drawing. We can even try to remove the sketch to see it better. I will only fix it here. And I'm using this brush because it has a soft edge. Okay. Let me bring back all the layers, so we can continue. If we check our color palette, for now it has only 5 colors. And in the last step, I want to draw the nose, so we need to pick some shade of pink from the photo. Let me try this one. I think it is a little too dark, so I will go a little lighter. This color may work. Let me also tap here in the color palette, so you will get it. And I will draw the nose on the same layer as all the base colors. Just painting following the sketch. We need to paint the entire area here. We will apply fur later, and also the lip can be the same color, and of course we will shade it. Now the first stage is over. We have applied all basic colors that we need. After coloring comes the smudging part. We need to work on this colored layer. If you want to have a copy of the layer and go back to it in case something goes wrong with smudging, there is a way to duplicate the layer and turn it off. Smudge tool can be found in this menu, and it looks like finger. Let's open the brush list and pick a brush for smudging. I'm going to use soft fur brush from my own fur brush set. It's included in the tutorial files. And first I want to apply it around the outer edge. Let's now remove the sketch and proceed. When smudging, we should always consider the direction of hairs on the reference photo. Let's now set the brush size to around 15% and start from the head. Here the hairs go to the right. I'll start making the strokes in this direction. And I'm pressing on the pencil. We can also try to make strokes in both directions to remove this sharp line and see how it goes. It may take some time, but in the end the result will look great and it will help us with building the fur texture later. I'm just going all over the edge. Let's have a look at it and continue. The bigger strokes you make, the more fluffy your guinea pig will look. I will try not to damage the ear, since they're on one layer. I'll make the size a little smaller here. Then bring it back and continue. Let's have a look what we have here. It goes to the side and a little up. So I'll just continue. I think we can increase the brush size a little to make it a little faster, because we will cover bigger areas. Also making it in two directions, outside and inside. This edge seems to be done. Let's continue going down. This is a little more fluffy, so I will make longer strokes. Right now our aim is to remove all the sharp lines and turn them into fur. This brown part is finished. We can go on the left side. I will lower the brush size again, because we have a smaller area here. And I will start making the strokes outside and inside again. It will go a little down here. Let's make it more fluffy. And then I will smudge this part with dark brown color. As we can see, it's not very fluffy. So I will make smaller strokes. But work in both directions as well. I think this is the result that I wanted to achieve. I'll keep it. Then I will continue to smudge this edge at the bottom with a bigger brush size, so it will get more fluffy. And the fur goes like this, with some curves. Right after we smudged the edge, we need to blend the colors inside the shape. Let's start with this light part on the forehead. And we need to do it in this direction. Go a little up and to the right. I will adjust the brush size a little. Make it around 20%. And make the strokes same way, back and forth. Let's try to keep this M shape. I need to have a look on this edge. And we can see that it goes mostly up. On the photo it's not so fluffy, but we will fix it with brushes later. Right now we are doing only smudging part. Let's go to the right from here. Add these hairs. If we lower the brush size, we can be more accurate. But it will take a little more time. so it's up to you. From here it'll change the direction a little and go down. Let's continue making the strokes, going even more down. Here I will make a stroke inwards to separate it with orange part a little. Alright, let me stop for a second and have a look at it. Maybe we can switch to the left side for now. I'll increase the brush size a little and start smudging it here. Also paying attention to the direction. Make sure the strokes don't go outside the ear, because it is not fluffy at all. We need to smudge only this border between the ear and the light fur. I will make the brush size a little lower to make these hairs. From here it will go more to the side. And light color is mixing with orange a little. Let's go more to the side. Smudge the entire border, and from here it will go a little down. We have a little more white color on this part, so we can make strokes outside. From here I will go inwards to keep the orange. And I will bring back the sketch to see this line that we defined for the cheek. So I will make it the following way, separating these two colors and adding some orange on the lip, the small part. I'll remove the sketch now and continue smudging the lip. Let's remove the border between orange and white color here. And then smudge the orange color at the lower part of the cheek. It goes down on this dark brown color. After we did that, we can also smudge the border between these two dark brown colors. It goes a little to the left. We can do it quickly with a bigger brush size. And after that we need to smudge the border between dark brown and light color here at the bottom. I will make strokes this way. This part is a little confusing, but we will figure it out. Let's try to lower the brush size and first start smudging this area, going down. After that I will also smudge the border between these two colors, making the waves. And defining the direction of the hair. You can make it a little up. Like this. Now let's fix the right part. I'll smudge it here. It's this border for the cheek. And then comes the neck. Here I will also make it wavy. We can increase the brush size. I will make a couple of more strokes and stop here. Now the smudging part with fur brushes is over. We can continue working on the drawing more detailed. And first I'd like to change the background color. We can pick it right from the photo. Create a new layer and place it under all layers. Then simply drag the color on the canvas. We have a few small parts that we can add highlights and shadows to. For example, we can see a small highlight on this ear. It is very easy to make. I'll just pick a color from here. It's this one. And go to the drawing. I think I will also save this stage by duplicating the layer. And turn it off. Then I will go to airbrushing set and pick soft brush. Make the size very low, around 1%. And add this highlight. Then I will go to smudge tool and select the same brush. Also lower the size and set opacity to around 70%. Smudge the edges very carefully. I think I will also alpha lock the layer, so the strokes don't go outside. I'll do it gradually, so the colors blend very well. From distance it looks fine. Now I'd like to work on the eye. And let me do this. I will go to the layer with the photo, outline the eye, and copy and paste it. I'll just move it closer, scale it, and drag it on top. This way I will see the location of the highlights and light reflections. Let's go to the layer with this black circle, and I think we can create a layer above it. Then clip. I will start with this light reflection. Let me try to pick the color from here. It's some shade of blue. I'll add it to the palette. We have already soft brush selected, but actually I think I will switch to medium hard airbrush. Its edges are not so soft. And I will try to recreate this shape. It goes like this. And then I'm just painting inside it. We can also see this light color here. Let me select it and also add it to the palette. I will draw it here, inside the blue shape. And there is also dark color. I'll draw it here. After that, I will smudge all the colors inside the shape, using soft brush from airbrushing. I've set the size to 2% and started smudging the colors. First inside. I think I will also smudge the edges a little. And grab eraser. That I will set to the same brush. Let me erase it a little from here. Now looks better. I just want to highlight this part a little more. And I think I can do it using pure white color. We can pick it from the disk. I'll draw more here. then also smudge it. Now that's better, I think. We can also see this small highlight under this shape. I'd like to use this blue color and change the brush to light pen from Luminance. It's a default Procreate brush. I will just draw this small shape here and smudge it a little on one side. Alright, there is also a big highlight at the bottom of the eye. I'm not sure if you can see it, but we need to show it to add volume to the eye. I'll do it on a separate layer that I will create between these two, and it will be clipped right away. I'll select pure white color and also change the brush. Here I will select medium hard airbrush. Increase its size and draw off the bottom of the shape. It goes this way. And after that, I will grab eraser that is already set to soft brush. We can set the size to around 5% and start erasing, not pressing too much on the pencil. I will lower the brush size a little and erase more on this edge. Then continue erasing on this part, so it will turn into light gray instead of white. This small part is a little whiter, so I will keep it. In the layers it looks like this. I think we can add a highlight going a little upper. I will just lower the opacity and start painting slightly. Then also erase it to make it not so visible. Alright, let's consider it done. Maybe only a small line here. Close to the corner. This time I will smudge it. Okay. Now it looks like shining glass. I will still keep this image because we will need to highlight the area around the eye as well. I think I'll just move it. For now, I'll just want to fix this shape a little. I'll pick this color, go back to the layer with fur, and using this medium hard airbrush, I will make this edge a little thicker, just as it is shown on the reference photo. Maybe we can also merge all the layers for the eye, and I will use liquify to make this edge go a little inside. This way it follows the shape of the eye. Okay, let's keep it for now. And I'd like to work on the nose. Let me now go and bring back the sketch, so we can see the nostrils and other details located inside the nose shape. I will also remove this eye. And we need to pick the colors from the photo. First, I will pick dark shades for the nostrils. Let's make sure it's not too dark. And I will add this color in the palette. I want to apply this color using medium hard airbrush. it's in full opacity, and I will keep the size at around 5%. Draw two arcs, one on top and another one at the bottom. Looks like Nike logo, almost. With the same color I will draw the second nostril. We can see only one side of it. Let me make it more like an arc. Then I will draw this line, the other one, and this line in the middle. We also need to separate the nose from the lip with these two lines. And I'd like to darken the lower part of the lip. We don't need the sketch now. And in addition to dark colors, we need to pick light color for the highlight. It needs to be lighter than the base color that we used on the nose. I think I will go to the color disk and make it a little lighter and more pink. I will also add it to the palette. Let's apply this color on the side from this nostril, under it, also on top of the nose, and around this nostril. Once we applied all these colors, we need to smudge them. I'll add more color here, and now we can proceed to smudging. I will use soft brush. Make opacity around 60 or 55%. So we can do it gradually. And the size can be set to 2%. I want to start with this dark line in the middle. I will just go along the line and then smudge it a little to the left. Make the size a little lower. Then make the circular strokes. After that, I will smudge this dark line here. And the highlights. Also this shape. Around the nostril. On top of the nose. And we need to smudge this nostril. Mostly on top. I will adjust this shape a little. And then proceed to the second nostril. I think we can also fix the shape to make it a little smaller, because we can see only a small part of it. Most of it is hidden because of the angle. We can also smudge this dark line so we get the nose shape, which is a little more complicated than the nose of a cat or a dog, I think. I'd like to add more dark color and then smudge it again. Like this. I'll make a couple of strokes in this direction. Also here, we can see some darkness. And then I will go to the lips. Here I will smudge it at the lower part to add a cast shadow. Smudging it very carefully. Let's work on this edge as well. On this one. And then blend these two colors in the lower part of the lip. Very carefully. I'll make more strokes inwards on this side. Continue blending. And soften the edge. Let me finish blending here. I'll make a few more strokes on the lip. And I think it is fine. Now I will change the smudge tool for the soft fur and smudge the edge here on top of the nose. But I will lower the brush size to 9%. Start making the strokes the following way. We can see some hairs that are transitioning from the nose on the snout. They also go to this side. And I'm doing it very carefully. Here it is not smudged. I'll make a couple of strokes here and then go to this part. We can slightly increase the brush size and start smudging it here. I will make these strokes as curves. Also in both directions. Same as we smudged the borders between the colors before that. Just with a smaller brush size. We can see some hairs going on the nostril, here, and then I will switch to the opposite side. Also smudge it this way. Here we will also work with fur brushes later. For now we just need to create this transition. Let's try to make it not so wide. I'll make more strokes on this side of the nostril. And I think it is enough. Since we are on this area, we can continue working on the snout. I'll pick some light color from the head. If we check its value, it's not totally white. And I will add it on the palette. Finally, I will go to fur brushes and select soft fur. I will set the size to around 50% and start making the strokes on this area where it is light. We can lower the size, increase the opacity and make even more strokes. But we can't keep it totally light. We can see some dark hairs here as well. So I will pick some dark color, maybe from here. Adding it to the palette. Then making the brush size smaller. And I will start drawing this way. To introduce these darker strands between the light hairs. I'll increase the brush size again and continue. Let's pick the color that is even darker from the area closer to the nose. Also adding it and drawing this way. I will go on the right side from the nose. Then pick some color from here, which is even darker. I will also add it on the palette and then draw on this side. Right now we are creating this under fur. Here I'm not pressing on the pencil at all. Just making numerous strokes, slightly, considering the direction of the hairs. It is also dark here. And on this fur under the lip. Let me pick the color from here. It goes to the palette as well. And I will darken this area. Continue drawing slightly, without applying too much pressure. I will also darken it on this side. And here. It may go in the opposite direction. Let's paint slightly here. I will make a few more strokes to create this darker under fur. I will press a little more with a lower brush size, especially on these areas. Also very close to the nose. Here. On this side of the lip, and it will continue here, this line. Let me bring back the sketch so we can see all the directions that we need to follow. I will darken this area even more by pressing on the pencil, looking at the reference all the time. Because it helps a lot. After that, I will go back to this light color and apply it again, but with a lower size, so we can still see this dark color that we applied. I will go to this side, then make the strokes in this direction. We can remove the sketch for now and continue making the strokes with this fur brush. I try to keep some gaps between the dark and white colors, so it makes more sense. Let's work on this side a little. I will continue making the strokes on this part to lighten it. Trying to mix these colors. And also add these light hairs that go a little on the orange part. We can lower the size even more. Here I'm not pressing too much, so we can't see from where the hair starts to grow. It needs to be smudged. I will lighten this part. Also here a little. And I'd like to add some hairs on this part of the nose, not pressing on the pencil at all. It is all covered by hairs. They go to this side, a little down on the lip, here. And on this nostril. I will paint slightly in the middle and on this edge. These hairs grow very close to the nostril, almost cover it. I will continue. I think if we check the number of strokes in the end, it will be a lot. This part is more white. I'll try to blend the colors here. And maybe paint slightly on this part to blend the colors as well. I think I will soften this edge a little. So I will switch to soft brush in the smudger. Just go along the edge. Let's keep it like this for now. Now let's switch to this part. It is the biggest one. And we need to pick some dark color from the fur, like this brown. I'm also adding it to the palette. Here I will also use soft fur brush. If you want, you can also duplicate this layer and keep it. I will set the brush size to 50% and also use the sketch. I will start making the strokes this way, not pressing, just following the direction of the hairs. I want to cover the entire area like this to create this under fur. Here it goes down. We have a few layers of this fur. Here it is more curvy. Then it goes to the side, just as we smudged. We have this cheek, and the hair goes in this direction. I'll make the size a little smaller, so we get thinner hairs. And continue. Let's work on top of the head a little. Go to this side. Still following the direction. And I will work here around the eye. This way. Then on the side. I'm still keeping some gaps with this light brown color, but covering most of it. Let's not forget this area. I will draw slightly here. I think this is enough. It will be our first furry layer. We need to do the same here. I will first pick some darker color. Put it here and draw with the fur brush. Here I will pick the color from this side and make it slightly darker on the color disk. Make the strokes with the fur brush. Okay. I think enough of this. Let's work on this area around the eye a little. We need to smudge it. And I will use fur brush, that is soft fur. Make the size low. And start smudging the edges. On this corner. Then also go up around this edge. Here it goes up like this. I'm smudging it very carefully. Let's work on this edge a little. And then I will add the highlights that we can see here. Let me pick this light color that is bluish or grayish. And I will use medium hard airbrush with a very low size. We have this eye that we can look at. I will start drawing here. Also in this corner, very close to the eye, and also on top of it. We can see this line here. Now let's try to smudge it. Using soft brush. I will not press too much on the pencil. And go along the color. We just need to blend the borders. I will work on this area. And then on top. Let me blend it a little more. Here. And then we can continue working with her brushes. We already don't need this eye. Let's go back to this dark color that we used on the fur. And also change the brush to soft fur shader. This brush is set to multiply mode, so the strokes will get darker. I will just lower the brush opacity to 83%, set its size to 15%, and I need to see the sketch. So we will apply this color on darker areas. We can see it here. I'm not pressing, but making many strokes on the same area. So this color gets darker. We can also see it here. On this line. We can increase the size a little. I'll continue. Also around the ear. This way. On top of the head. On this border with white color. Closer to the edge. Here the strokes don't go outside because the layer is alpha locked. We did that before. I will draw more on the edge to darken it. Then also on this area. It goes as an arc. Here it is also dark. We can see this curl. Then it goes to the right here. Let's continue to build this contrast. I'll darken it here. Then continue on this arc. We can see these dark hairs everywhere. So we can draw slightly on this area as well. Okay. Let me draw here, close to the eye, to darken it, around the eye a little. Also on this border with white color. Let's see how it looks without sketch. It is already getting some pattern. I'll make more strokes here and there, just to soften it. No pressure. Just building the soft fur. Let me make a few strokes here. And then we can add the highlights. And for that we need to pick the color from the photo. It needs to be light. So we can find it in this area. Something between orange and light brown. I'll add it to the palette. In the brushes I will go back to soft fur in normal mode and make the size low, around 5 or 6%. We can also use the sketch to see the borders between the colors that we defined earlier. I will start with this area and make the strokes at some distance from each other to keep the dark color as well. And I'm not pressing too much on the pencil. This way it will look more natural. We also need to follow the direction of the hair growth that we see on the photo. We can show the hairs here. Also keeping dark color. And following the direction. It goes to this side. In some areas we can press a little more to get a lighter color. Here it goes strictly to the right. But still I'm not pressing too much. Let's continue drawing around the eye, keeping this direction to the right. This area is a little more highlighted, so we can press a little more. Let's draw on top of the eye, because it is also light. We can see some light hairs here, on the edge, close to the ear, and actually on the entire area, just not so many. This pattern is a little complicated, but still we can try to repeat it. I will draw here, then go down, making the strokes to the right side. Let's work on this area a little. Here we can see longer hairs, so we can try to increase the brush size to 12% and draw like this, making curly strokes, and go to this direction. We can see some light area here. Then a few hairs on this part. They go to the right. And on this dark part as well. Let me draw more here. Also, we can see this on the left side. It's a mix of colors. On this area, they can be longer inside this part. And they're changing the direction. We still need to keep some dark color to preserve the shading. Let's work a little more on this area. And now I think I will remove the sketch to see it better. And continue drawing the light fur. Let's add this pattern here, close to the ear. It goes a little down. I just want to make the drawing look close to the photo, but still keep the process simple, so you can follow it. Let's continue making strokes here. I'll try to highlight it even more. And then work on this edge. Here we can see some hairs going down. They change the direction. And I will draw a few hairs here. Remember that we are not pressing. Just tapping on the canvas. Let's work on this side a little more. And I think I will switch to dark color again. And also change the brush to shader. Just want to fix the pattern a little. I will add more dark hairs here, so we can see the border better. Also on this part, to get a deeper shadow. And maybe here. We can switch between these two colors and brushes as much as needed, until we are fully satisfied with the pattern. I'll draw here to blend these two colors and also randomize the pattern a little. Okay, let me now have a look at it. I'll add a couple of hairs on this part, and then I want to go even lighter, so I'll select this color again, but this time switch to software highlighter. We can work on this side, because we can see that this color is slightly lighter. So I will start drawing here, and since this brush is set to screen mode, it is getting lighter. Let's blend it with this white fur. And once it is highlighted, we can also work on the right side with this brush. I think I will draw more here. Mostly on the tips. And also around the eye. We can make the brush size 5%. And continue tapping on the canvas. Here it is closer to the eye. Some hairs can be longer. And then I will also highlight this area here, close to the eye corner. And then under the eye. Go to this side. Let's highlight it here a little, because to me the guinea pig looks a little angry. Now that's better. I'll highlight it more. Also add to the pattern with this lighter color. And highlight some hairs here, just a tiny bit. And on the cheek. Let's add some longer hairs to show the shape. There is a line here. And maybe I think we can stop with the fur brush for now. I'll paint slightly here. And now I think we can stop working with the fur brush. We need to shade this ear. Let's see what we got on the reference photo. We can see this black border, a little highlight, and some hairs. Let's try to recreate it on the drawing. And I want to keep this soft border on the right side of the ear. We can do it if we use selection. Let's go here, pick freehand and outline this edge very carefully. I'll start from here. And strictly follow the shape. We can try to tap. Then here. And then I will outline this edge as well. By tapping along the side. Let's close the selection. And go to the color disk to pick black color. Make sure color fill is off. We also need to pick the brush. And it can be medium hard airbrush from airbrushing. Let's make it full opacity. And adjust the size. I'll set it to 10%. And draw on the edge. It doesn't go outside because it is selected. If we look here, we can see that it goes lower. You can even use the sketch if you wish. To repeat this shape. I will shade it at the bottom a little. And after that increase the brush size and lower its opacity. To around 55-60%. I will start shading this part slightly to darken it. Also inner part of the ear, not pressing too much on the pencil, and here on top. Actually, it is highlighted mostly in this area. And we can look at the reference photo. After that we need to add the highlight and also fur. For the highlight we can try to use this light gray color. It goes close to the edge here and slightly on this side. Let's lower the brush size, but keep it low opacity. I'll start drawing slightly here, then continue on this side. Let's increase the brush size a little and continue highlighting it. Let me try to make it a little brighter. And here I will apply fur brush. We can use this orange color that we already used on the fur. Also in the fur brushes I will pick soft fur in normal mode. Let's try to make the size small. And draw like this. Going to the side. It covers mostly the edge. Let's add a little hair on this part. And it is a little messy, so it may go in different directions. Just as on the photo. Maybe a few more. Then I will deselect, go to smudge tool and set it to soft brush. It is set to 60% opacity and I will make the brush size around 1 or 2%. I just want to make this edge a little softer. I will go along the side. And here as well. Let's smudge it here and at the lower part. This part will be fixed, no worries yet. It is soft now, and we need to smudge this border between the ear and fur. For that we need to change the smudge tool for soft fur brush. It is in low brush size, and I will make the strokes inside the ear to remove the border. I will make strokes mostly inside the ear, but also go outwards to remove this border completely. Just as we did while smudging inside the shape when we applied colors. Let's work here. And to hide this smudged area completely, we can apply the brush. I will start with dark color and shade the brush. Make a few strokes to this side. I think we could do it earlier, but even now it is fine. We'll still look natural. Let's see how it goes on the photo. Some hairs are long and curvy. Let's do it the same. We can lower the size a little. And after that we can add a few light hairs using this orangey color and soft fur highlighter. I will make the size low and add a few hairs. Make them long too. And with some curves, so they cover the ear slightly. Now this ear is done. We can make a few adjustments on the entire drawing. As I said before, we can fix this part. And also here. There are some hairs behind the ear. We can create a layer below this one. Pick some color from the edge. And soft fur brush. Just make the strokes on this side. Same here. But on this side, the hairs are mostly light. We can pick some color from here and draw to this side slightly. This way it'll look more natural and more like on the photo. We can add some dark color here that we can pick right from the photo, so the transition is smooth. Now that's better. Let's see what else we can do. I think we can smudge this line on the nose to make it a little more blurry. We can go to smudge tool and try to use soft fur. I will just go along this line. Let's go back to the layer with the fur and then smudge along the line. To the sides. Like this. Also, I'd like to work on the lip a little. Let's try to smudge the lower part of the lip using fur brush. I will make strokes inwards and outwards. Here we can try to lower the brush opacity. And make these small strokes. I will also smudge this edge a little more, making the strokes down. We can also try to connect these two lines. to get a darker shade, like on the photo. I'll smudge a little here and make this light area a little more narrow, also by smudging it. But these adjustments totally depend on the result that you got after applying for brushes. If it turned out quite well, you don't have to do that. I will work a little more here. And I think also we can shade this part a little more. Make this edge lighter and darken this part. Let's pick the color from here. And we can use softer brush. I'll try to lower the opacity to around 80% and make more strokes on this part. Also here. We can see some dark line on this part. Let's edit. Here the reference photo helps a lot. Let's try to add some light colors as well. I will go with this one. And just try to smudge it. To make this edge soft. The size can be smaller. I will also lighten this area by adding more hairs. If we look at the photo more careful, we can see that some hairs are very thick, not as soft as the entire fur. We can also try to do that. In this set I have a few other brushes. We can try dog fur for instance. I will make it full opacity and set the size to around 5 or 4%. Let me start adding these hairs on the white part. Let go outside the shape. They go to this side as well. Here close to the eye. Then to this side. I will draw more going down and add these hairs. Let's also draw a few to this side. They go outside on the ear and then on this cheek. In addition to these hairs, we also need to add the whiskers. And we can change the brush for that. I'll just finish it here. Add a few hairs inside. And then go to the brush set to pick single hair brush. We can add whiskers on another layer that we can create above this one. I will set the brush size to around 11 or 10%. We can use the sketch and draw them by outlining. We can see some curly hairs and they go in different directions. Some of them go on the nose, to this side, then to the right. We can make a few more hairs go this way. Let's see how it looks. we may need to smudge the beginning of the hairs using soft fur brush. So it looks more natural on the drawing. Okay, I think I will do one final touch. I will unlock the layer and add some random hairs around the shape that are longer. I will be picking colors from the edge and using this dog fur brush with a low brush size at around 3% or maybe 4%. Just add these hairs. Maybe we can add a few light hairs as well. And also here. Both dark hairs and light ones. Now we need to save the drawing. And we also need to crop it before saving. We can do it easily if we go to Actions, Canvas, and click Crop and Resize. I'll just drag this edge to the right. Make this distance the same as on the right. Then click Done. And now it is ready. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for notifications about new videos. Another way to support me is to join me on Patreon, where you can access even more tutorials and brush sets. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you soon.